fact, I believe the situation in Iraq lends itself strongly to our national security interests. In fact, one of the problems with the administration's handling of this is that after what is widely considered to be a successful surge, experts said that in fact having a presence of troops left him on the ground in Iraq to be a stabilizing force was very important. But the president had a commitment, I believe motivated, for political reasons, to withdraw every American, from Iraq and be sure that it was done in a timeline that he announced to the world. And I think that put us in an unstable situation, because even as soon as last November, when he was asked questions about the potential threat of ISIS taking over that area in Syria and Iraq and expanding in its aim of achieving an Islamic caliphate over the globe, he just kind of brushed it off sarcastically, saying, if a JV team puts on Lakers uniforms, that doesn't make you Kobe Bryant. Now, fast forward, we had a huge crisis where, in fact, I think we did fulfill what was an important moral obligation to help the Yazidis trapped on Mount Sinjar. I think that was extremely important. I'm really proud we did that. But unfortunately, experts now today are saying that due to the completely unmanageable situation there, where ISIS has seized troops we provided to the Iraqis, they seized oil fields, they have billions of dollars. They're one of the richest terrorist organizations in the history of terrorism, basically. That in fact we may have to consider, bringing troops back, and that would be really unfortunate. It's not what we want, but I think at this point all things are going to be considered, and that's because we did not have clear leadership about our role in the world and our role and responsibility in that region.
Thanks very much.